NBC2 News at 3 starts in just a few minutes. I'm Kyla Gaylor out here at the Sanibel Boat Ramp for NBC2 First Alert Hurricane Week, and we are kicking things off with a very special edition of What's on Rob's Radar.
Flooding is expensive to recover from, but there's things we can do to lessen the sting before big bills stack up after big storms. Everglades City has done some of those things, because years before Ian, this town took the brunt of storm surge from another hurricane, Irma, in 2017.
The full force of the storm and the northern eye wall, and now that northeastern quadrant moving onshore over Marco Island, down 41 toward Everglades City.
That full force pushed 3 feet of water into the buildings of Everglades City School, racking up a bill of more than $930,000, a figure seemingly unfathomable, at least at the time.
This is not something that you will ever see again in your lifetime. If you're watching,
we hope not.
Hope wasn't enough.
Of Hurricane Ian.
5 years later to the month, another disaster barreled toward us, and this one was worse.
So I understand Hurricane Irma brought in 3 feet of floodwaters. I understand Hurricane Ian brought in 6 feet of floodwaters onto this campus.
But this isn't a sad story. Instead, thanks to the efforts spearheaded by Mark Rulo, this is a story of preparedness and saving you money.
We came out on the best side of Hurricane Ian.
When you think about the flood mitigation measures that Collier County has put into this school, when you stand inside Everglades City School's courtyard, you can almost think of this place as a fortress that's best seen from up above.
Based on the damage done in 2017, Collier County Schools forged a two-pronged defense of this campus against rising water. Prong one, stop it from getting in. That's accomplished by encasing the school with a 6-foot-high flood wall.
And the flood wall has integrated floodgates. So the floodgates, when they're in the lowered position, they allow people and equipment to come and go. And so when they're in the upright position, they create a watertight barrier in the campus. And so it's great for keeping the flood water out.
Prong two, protect the campus by pumping water that gets in, out. That's done through a network of gutters, drains, and grates, enticing water here toward a central lift station.
It triggers the pump to come on, and then that pump drains the stormwater from the interior of the campus, and it pushes it through an underground pipe out to the river.
After Ian, the results spoke for themselves.
The prior hurricane had taken out a lot of the buildings in the school, and there was major renovation that had to take place. And so when I found out that they actually worked and everything was safe and dry, there's no words.
Principal Sherry Allison's relief was multi-tiered. Not only did her school survive a bigger storm with less damage, it also came with a smaller cleanup tab. Rulo says after Irma, FEMA recovery dollars became a finite resource.
They're not going to pay that again. So that's why mitigation effort is so important, to prevent future damage and, you know, relying on your insurance carrier to pay for it. You know, I don't know that insurance carriers would pay over and over. I mean, if this damage occurred once every 3, 4, 5 years, who's going to be willing to pay for that?
As this town hopes its efforts will be enough to hold back the waters of the next big storm.